Welcome back to the channel, guys. I'm Matt, and today we're going to be doing a public speaking reaction video to Bo Burnham's 2021 special, Inside. Now, I was expecting this special to be him performing some songs and then to kind of imitate the stand-up comedy setting, but he goes way beyond expectation. It is insane. For some context, he shot the whole thing in one room. He edited, wrote, and directed the entire thing himself. I highly, highly, highly recommend you check it out. Just bear in mind, though, like a lot of comedies, it's definitely not a PG-13 watch.
But the truth is, I turned 30 in less than a minute. So I'm just going to sit here and enjoy my 20s and then get back to work.
So what's he doing here? Well, he wants to portray this vulnerable, sad moment. He's turning 30, and that's a big deal. Turning 30 is a landmark moment. Normally you'd celebrate with friends, but he's alone in his room, zero celebrating. In fact, even worse, he's gonna go back to work as soon as he turns 30. But what's so amazing, what's so brilliant about this scene is that it feels so real, so authentic. Even though the reality is that he might have shot this 10, 15, 20 times. So the question then is, how does he make something that he scripted word for word feel for us like it's the very first time he's ever articulated those thoughts in his mind? And he does that by adding in moments of imperfection and by doing things that are very difficult to fake. And that's why it feels so real. The first thing we notice is that his legs bouncing up and down and he's spinning something with his hand. These are clear signs of restlessness and anxiousness. Difficult things to fake.
I wanted to finish this thing before I turned 30.
You see those long pauses that he does as well? That just makes it feel like he's searching for those words. And when he looks down to think, that's what we normally do when we're trying to access emotional memories or we're just trying to feel something. At one point, he also does a shivering inhale of breath. Like, this tells us that this is hard for him to talk about. It's painful.
Because the idea of turning 30.
Whenever he stops talking, all you can hear is crickets. This just amplifies how sad the moment actually is. And you really feel for him. You'll notice as well that he isn't even at the center of this shot. The clock is. The clock is in the spotlight. And this is a great example of how to dictate where the audience's attention should go. When he wants us to look at the clock, he doesn't say, look at the clock. He simply looks at it. And then we look at it. So when you're doing a presentation, if you want the audience to turn their attention towards a prop or a slide, you simply look at it. That will raise the value of that object, and then the audience will look at it. And when the clock hits midnight, his body language is of someone who's just defeated, who feels hopeless. It's a great example of low status body language. His shoulders hunched over, his head's tilted down. He's taking up as little space as possible, crouched over. His posture is of somebody who just feels completely hopeless. And it's a combination of all these things, the moments of imperfection, the intentional mistakes, doing things that are hard to fake, that made us feel like he was being completely authentic, vulnerable, genuine, and that he was speaking those words for the first time in his life.
Hey everybody, I just wanted to make a really quick video to say thank you. Thank you for watching my content. As you guys know, I work really hard to try to bring you guys high quality content that I think you'll enjoy. So the fact that you are enjoying it means everything to me. So thank you. And also, keep watching, because there's a lot more content where that came from. All right, guys. See you later.
Now, this clip is a great example of how to be inauthentic. The last one was a great example of how to be authentic, how to be believable. This is what not to do. He's doing a tongue-in-cheek impression of a YouTuber with a real fake, insincere delivery. When he performs this shot, something just feels off. It doesn't quite add up. But what is it specifically about what he's doing that makes it feel so wrong? There's a few things. The first thing is his voice. It sounds very rehearsed. It sounds scripted. We're less likely to believe what he's saying.
No, I work really hard to try to bring you guys high quality content.
He's got one hand out here like this, and it's doing absolutely nothing. It's just randomly there. It's not functional at all. And when there's a lack of synchronicity between your face, your voice, and your body, it just feels like something's off. And when something feels off, we're less likely to believe you. He's smiling pretty much the whole take, and it's kind of like, are you actually that happy? Is that a bit fake? He throws in the fake laugh.
A lot more content where that came from.
And then finally, he's got the knife. This is just one more thing that looks out of place. Why is he holding a knife? But then on top of that, when he's asking us to keep watching the videos, he's smiling at us while he's pointing the knife in our face. So we're kind of like, okay, are you threatening us or are you being nice to us? It's pretty confusing. And the scene ends with a way too long smile, holding the knife. Overall, this is just a great example of how not to communicate.
5 years ago, I quit performing live comedy because I was beginning to have severe panic attacks while on stage, which is not a great place to have them. So I quit. For 5 years, I spent that time trying to improve myself mentally.
This whole section is a great example of the power of speaking from the heart. I've seen professional public speakers come up and they're so polished. They do everything by the book, but they don't really connect with the audience. The audience doesn't feel anything. And on the other hand, you see some other people come up and they're nervous. They're stumbling. They're looking down, they make mistakes. But they talk so honestly, so sincerely. And they say something that's real, that's personal. They open up about something hard for them to talk about. And the audience is completely silent. You could hear a pin drop. That is the power of speaking from the heart. And Bo Burnham is a master at it. By the way, this song, All Eyes On Me, I mean, incredible. I feel like Bo Burnham now, he's writing world-class music. This song, I see it being played at a festival. It's dark out. It's the last song of the evening. Everyone's got their phones up, their torches turned on. They're swaying side to side. It's that good a song. Bo Burnham is an inspiration for anyone who's trying to improve their craft. And the reason is that every time he does a special, his singing gets better, his songwriting gets better, his production gets better. And what's so amazing is this huge range, the spectrum of genres he can write music in. He does 1980s electro, disco, carnival theme, R&B, pop, hip-hop. I mean, it seems like he can write a hit in any genre. Who does that? What a talent this guy is. I am truly blown away by this special. One of the hardest things to do for performers is to make people just feel something. Because that means you've connected with them on a deep level. And Bo could have just put out all these amazing songs, these amazing music videos, and we all would have just stood back and said, hey, he's a genius. But what he also did was he showed us the more unglamorous side of the creative process. The messy apartment, pulling out the sofa bed, the take after take after take in the middle of the night. And so importantly, he let us into the psyche of his own mind by showing us all the demons, the insecurities, the pain, and all the creative stuff is so impressive, but it's those vulnerabilities that let us connect with him. It made me actually care about him. I felt like after watching this, I wanted to reach out to him, send him an email, make sure he's okay, tell him I love the special. It's the vulnerabilities that make you seem human and that make us feel something and connect with you. I was expecting this special to be some funny songs and some stand-up comedy. But to call it a comedy is doing it a disservice because it was so much more than that. Yeah, it was a comedy, but it was also a musical, a drama, a satire. It was philosophical, profound, topical, emotional. It had a little bit of everything, all different levels. And what I still just can't get my head around is how he shot the whole thing by himself in one room. I mean, you would have sworn there was a crew in there, that there was a whole production team. But no, he did all the video editing, the angles, the lighting, the effects, the acting. I mean, it's amazing. I feel like people are going to be analyzing this special for years. I've never seen anything like it before. Bo Burnham has created his own genre, and he's the only one in it because nobody else can do it quite like he can do it. I truly feel like this is a masterpiece. Bo Burnham, you are a genius. If you enjoyed the video, please do subscribe. You get more public speaking analysis and self-improvement ideas. See you in the next one.